Hey, Tuesday, good day. Hope it's a good day for you. So, come on in. Come on in and share a moment with me in my little world. Sometimes it's pretty small. I hope you're having a good day. But you know, some days are tough. Some days you got to face some things that you don't want to face, but you just got to do them because you know that they're needed to accomplish the goals and so forth you want in life, or to serve a greater cause. They're just days like that. I remember being a young boy, and a fellow wanted to come and get me while I was away with my father on a trip, and he was doing some speaking at a place, and a fellow said, "Let me come and get you and take you someplace." And I didn't know the guy. I can tell you what happened. He had a meat packing plant, which that might have been interesting, except they weren't cutting any meat that day. They weren't packing any meat that day. About the most interesting thing I found there were some guys who spoke a language I didn't understand who were killing flies around the place. Well, the old man that took me there went back in an office and fell asleep in a chair. But my dad told me, sometimes you do things because that's what you just got to do. How would you like to be Amy Coney Barrett right now? There she sits, being under the spotlight of Inquisition for several days. And yeah, I know the end result and so forth. And regardless of what side of the politics you may be on, whether you like her or don't like her, that's immaterial right now. How would you like to be in her shoes? I think I'd be inclined to jump up and say, "Are you morons or something?" Not very pleasant. That's not very politically correct to me, is it? Okay. But sometimes you face some tough stuff, and she is right now dealing with that as she faces those questions and those ideas that are put out to her, and the unrelenting inquisition that's taking place, and the politics that are involved. It's something. Most of us would just as soon not be involved in any way at all, I think. But we realize that's part of who we are, where we are, what we do as a people, and so forth. Sometimes it's tough, but I thought about that in the light of you want to be in the face of God. How would you like to stand before God and answer His questions? In that Old Testament book of Job, he kept wondering why God was doing to him, what He was doing to him. And in the end, God says, "Okay, let me question you." He wasn't ready for those questions, was he? If you know the story, you know what I mean. But I think about those who stand before God, and I think about what Jesus taught there in Matthew 7, some of the most terse statements he makes in all of his ministry. When in verse 21 of Matthew 7, he says, "Not everyone that says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven." But he doesn't just stop there. He goes on to talk about, there's some way to come up and say, "Didn't we do this and didn't we do that in your name?" His response will be, "I never knew you. Depart from me." Sometimes we get hung up thinking we are doing what's needed when we're really just doing what we want. That's not an accusation. That's just an observation, if you will. That is probably pretty human in that regard. I guess what it comes down to is we've got to look and see, what is it that I need to do? What is it that God wants me to do? What is it that Jesus has shown me to do? There's another side to the coin, of course, and that's the mercy, the forgiveness of God. But the question still comes down to, have you sought what God really wants you to do? Maybe you learned a long time ago, if you were a student in school, that when you brought in a paper, you had to do it the teacher's way, because the teacher was in charge. When I was growing up, if I cleaned my room, it had to be my mother's way. You didn't get to just push everything in the closet or under the bed. You had to actually clean it up. I had to do it my mother's way. She was in charge. That's the way it is. And that's the way we deal with life. And you know what I found? When you do it that way, generally life works out better. Every one of my children, when they went off to school, or especially when they were in college studying, I would say, you feed back to the teacher exactly what the teacher wants, and you'll have a good experience. Now, that's not the complete answer, and I hope you understand that. I'm not talking about individuality or your beliefs in that regard, but understand what is wanted and address that, and things will come out very well. It works in most relationships. So when Jesus said, not everyone that just says to me, Lord, Lord, but it's the ones who actually did the will of God. When you seek what God wants, and you do what God wants, hey, you find yourself in the right position. I don't want to be in Amy Coney Barrett's position right now. I don't want somebody doing that kind of questioning and politicking before me. I don't want them to have to investigate my life inside and out. Probably wouldn't take them very long. But the reality is, find out what is wanted. Find out what is needed to accomplish the best, and then do that. That's, I think, what Jesus was getting at. You hear, you learn, you do, and things work out well. Sounds like a pretty good plan in life, if you think about it. I may not have stated it all exactly that well, but kind of like James and others have encouraged us, don't just be hearers, but be doers. Recognize that it's important. If you know what to do, just do it, and life works out for the better. God said it. Let's do it. And that'll be for the best. Hey, it's a good Tuesday. Good day to put some things into practice and apply them well in our lives. I thank you for spending a few moments with me, and I hope it's something that helps your day, helps you to do better today. Well, I have more to say down the way. Thanks for being with me.